be down under, but we're right up there when it comes to scandals and dust-ups. Writer Eamon Evans checked out some of the biggest and he joins us now. Morning, Eamon.
Good morning. How
are
you doing?
Hey, let's start with Paul Keating and the famous Lizard of Oz headline. What was that when we all realised the Prime Minister shouldn't actually touch the royals?
Well, most of us have known for a few thousand years, actually, but clearly we forgot to tell Paul Keating. Yeah, all he really did was just try and help a little old lady through a crowd, but as far as the English tabloids were concerned, he may as well have tried to punch her.
Oh.
Yeah, Tony Abbott clearly wasn't paying too much attention because he did the same thing a few years later with Prince William. And then I think it was just last year that Prince Charles was here and he got... possibly got touched on the bum by a charity worker, which is not the sort of charity you had in mind.
Oh, well, whatever turns you on. Eamon, women have been breaking down barriers for a long time. What did you find out about Lola Montez and Annette Kellerman?
Well, Lola Montez deserves a show to herself, really, but the short story is that she was an erotic dancer from the 1840s from Ireland. She had a extraordinary sort of string of affairs all over Europe with sort of the Tsar of Russia, the King of Bavaria, Alexander Dumas, the author, Franz Liszt, the composer, about sort of 782 lords and quite a few chorus girls. She took her show to Australia in the 1850s. Fair to say it didn't go that well. One audience member called the police. Another one rushed on stage to try and put some clothes on her, and she got so sick of all the bad headlines from all the newspapers that she actually went to one newspaper office and attacked the editor with a horsewhip.
Oh,
wow!
Who was that? Oh, yeah, Annette Kellerman. Yeah, well, she was a very famous swimmer from about 1900, but she wasn't that good a swimmer. Tried and failed to swim the channel a few times, but she was mainly famous for just having a great body and moviegoers. She was from Sydney, but moviegoers got to see it. She was in a Hollywood movie in about 1920, the first woman to ever go topless, possibly, and yeah, the idea seemed to catch on. It's been done since then.
Just a few times.
There you go. I mean, look, I must say, I know how to feel. I often have people in the audience come and try and put clothes on me on the show. Now, I mean, as far as dust-ups are concerned, which is more memorable, the Normie Rowe versus Ron Casey showdown or James Packer versus David Kinchel? Gee, they're both good ones.
Mm. Yeah, no, they've both got a place in my heart. Casey v. Rowe happened on the Midday Show in the early 90s. They were debating whether Australia should become a republic, but the debate obviously got a bit out of hand. Packer v. Gingell, no one quite knows what that debate was about. I could probably speculate, but I'd need a few lawyers. I don't know, they were both good. Probably my favourite was Packer's uncle, Clyde Packer, back in the 60s. He was on the front page of the Telegraph with a dart in his buttocks, having a punch on with a one-legged clergyman. And it was probably losing, really, all things considered.
Oh, my goodness.
Well, you know, the clergyman had God on his side.
Absolutely. The power of the Lord.
It's not a fair fight.
Now, for scandals, though, it's pretty hard to beat that underarm bowling incident. Mm. I remember as a little girl seeing that.
Mm. Yeah, well... the New Zealand Prime Minister called it the most disgusting incident in the history of cricket, and until some of Australia's recent one-day outfits, he was probably right. Basically, what happened was it was a one-day match in the early 80s. Australia was bowling. We were six runs ahead with one ball to go, and so Greg Chappell told his brother to bowl underarm to make sure no one got a six. Didn't go down that well. He didn't get fined or suspended or anything, but he got sort of called shameless, spineless, disgraceful, churlish, gutless, and all those sorts of things, which was a bit of a PR blow.
That was dirty, very dirty. I mean, speaking of cricket, didn't Shane Warne blame his mum for one of his misdemeanours?
Yes, he did. He did. He didn't get fined or suspended. He did get fined and suspended, actually. He got caught with a drug in his system, which... but he said it was just a diet pill that his mum had given him. And given sort of how vain he's proved to be in the years since then, I'm inclined to believe him.
It looks good, though.
Diet pills
work.
He looks excellent.
So skinny. Have a diet pill.
He was trying to lose fluid.
Just like
it makes fluid.
Yeah, it makes perfect
sense. Giant Ken doll.
Well, there are many more stories in Eamon Evans' book, Great Australian Scandals and Dust-Ups. Eamon, it's great to chat to you. Thanks for joining us.
Thank you so much.